So where are we?
I'm here with Philos Taverna at the Hellenic Club, celebrating Greek Independence Day, 200 years.
Beautiful.
And we're getting dressed up and ready to serve. The flags are out.
Are you Greek or something? Expecting a busy night?
There'll be a few around. Yeah. Luzo's ready to celebrate the corners.
Look at that.
See that my son's birthday today. Sipete Martino to Johnny.
So how long have you been a Greek?
All my life.
200 years?
All my life.
So where are you from?
Australia.
What part of Australia?
Canberra.
You're Canberra. Genuinely Canberran Greek. Bravo.
Canberra.
So what's it like being a Greek Canberran?
When you're passionate, you're Greek. You live for every day and live for the people here, looking after Greeks and serving everybody. Everybody in here. We love everybody. We're not racist. We love everybody. So multicultural.
You're not them and us.
No. It's all us. We're all together here. We're in it together. Happy Independence Day.
Happy Greek National Day, everyone.
Yeah, Greek National Day.
Hey, bravo. So what kind of Greek are you?
Huh?
So what kind of Greek are you?
There we go. Greek National Day.
So what kind of Greek are you?
I'm a first generation born Australian Greek. So here we are. I've been working at the Hellenic Club now for 22 years. 22 years, a long time. Seen lots of Greek National Days here.
Okay, well, Patriot here was hanged outside his church in Constantinople because he wasn't following the Ottomans' rules. My daughter's a historian, she can tell you all about that when I can. This one here, he blessed the flag of the War of Independence. And I'll tell you something very unusual about him. You can sit over there and he's looking at you, and you can sit over there and he's looking at you. Everywhere you go, he looks at you. And I hadn't picked up on it, visitors have picked up on it. So you can sit here and he's looking at you. You can go over there and he's looking at you.
Yeah, true.
It's very unusual.
So he blessed the flag. Now that was in, what year was that?
In 1821.
So that was it, so I was in, I went to Akata and then we caught that train up.
I painted them because I was depressed. 2018 I started, and I was living in Greece, and I was looking at Greece, and they had recession, and things were not too good, and I sort of got depressed, and I'm thinking of our heroes, and I'm thinking, we had heroes that fought for the freedom of this country, and now look at the state it's in, because of the Germans, because of this, because of that, you know.
And
the situation.
So
I started painting Kolokotroni, who was our general. And people were saying to me, why are you painting him? Who's interested in Kolokotroni? I said, I am. I'm not painting him to sell him. I'm just because I want him to live.
Yeah, that's right.
I want to bring him back. Because nobody paints these people anymore. Everybody's interested in painting things to commercial things. And that's how it started. And then a friend of mine saw it and said, Angela, it's wonderful. Paint them and have an exhibition in Sydney at the University of New South Wales. And that's how I start.
It's a beautiful story.
These are 16 pieces.
16?
Yeah. And it's taken me about 2.5 to 3 years. Because it takes a long time. To get the colour, the right colour, you've got to glaze its oil. So you've got to go over it. It's not just,
The colours do it for me.
See the ones behind you?
He died with the priest. That looks very innocent. In Thermopylae. Thermopylae is the place where the Anzacs fought with the New Zealanders and the 300 Spartans.
You tell me the women, we're just pushing.
The women over there, what happened was in the war, all the men had gone to war. And there was the women were alone with their grandmothers, mothers, children, and the Ottomans were coming in. And they were not going to allow the Ottomans to take them as captives. So they decided to suicide. So they sang a special song, a beautiful song, they danced, and they jumped off the cliff. And it happened in three places in Greece. But apparently it's happened in other parts of the world too. Women prefer to sue us, I'd rather get caught and become slaves.
But I hope you have an opportunity to look around, enjoy some food, have some coffee, some drinks, as well as the Hellenic Club. You know, there's a lot of food. If you want to eat it,
I'm the best. Lucomavis. Honey Pops.
Sorry?
What's happening today?
That's for the National Day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Country here. Από την κόψη του σπατιού τη τρομερή.
Tongas are more in Fiji as well. And so we have it like a ceremony of like weddings and like funerals.
This is beautiful.
You're back in action.
I haven't left, haven't stopped.
Now we've got traditional sweets. Dactyla, it's a very traditional Cypriot sweet and Greek.
What's it like having a president for mother?
It's a bit stressful. She's always working on a couple months prior to the Glendy, working on every day, trying to sort it out. So, yeah.
It's pretty amazing, isn't it?
It's good in the end.
Coffee? Sugar?
It's been really nice to see the different cultures that are on around you, whether it's through the food or through the entertainment. It's a nice outing, yeah.
Thank you. That's all there are for our children that's come all the way from Sydney.
Interesting too, sir. This painting here is the first Greeks that came to Australia. What happened with these people? Seven freedom fighters were caught in the Mediterranean by the British on a Maltese ship stealing maps. So they caught them, put them in shackles, brought them to Australia as convicts. So after 8 years, they found out they weren't convicts, they were actually freedom fighters, so they pardoned them. Five of them returned to Greece and two of them stayed in Australia and called Australian home. That's why this painting is called Patrida. Patrida means homeland. And it's Manolis Andonis, who's buried in Picton and worked on Governor MacArthur's property and started bringing in lettucing, the vines, and, you know, looking after the plants and the farm. And Gikas, Bulgaris, came near Canberra somewhere and became a sheep herder. But these are apparently, they're the first Greeks to
come. Limitable.
Today is a special day. Our special day here in Canberra and Queensland is the feast day of St. Nicholas. Today, the special events will be written in history. History is what we are made for thousands of years. Our history of the Greeks, our Orthodox race, everything that we owe is to God and our history. So now we'll be travelling at 2:30 this afternoon, and we're going to go to Nimitabur. And we have the honour, again, you and me, Manoli, to again go up there after nearly 19 years to honour Gikas Bulgaris, one of the seven people of Greek descent that come here. They arrived here in Australia in the year 1829, I think it was, and we can only follow the story of two of them. One is Antonis Manolis, and he is buried at the Picton Cemetery. Hugh Gilchrist, professor and a big Phil Hellene, found his grave because he loved the Greeks, and found out about these seven Greeks that the English at the time were thinking they were pirates. So he investigated the inimitable cemetery, the old cemetery.
867 years. Yeah. That means?
Settlement, that's pretty incredible, isn't it?
Probably the fellow who done the stone head.
So when we went there, where it was, only just the foundations were visible. And we were on it, and we could feel Gikas there, internally, that he was talking to us. My thought at the time was that we should do a burial for him at Trisayo, because he didn't have a Orthodox priest, didn't have a church here, didn't have anybody.
Καλώς ήρθαμε. It means welcome. And καλώς ήρθαμε εδώ στο Βούλγαρη Γκίκα το σπίτι.
Seems very old.
Θα ήταν ο Γκίκας εδώ πέρα πολύ μοναχός, ολομόναχος δηλαδή, χωρίς κανένα Έλληνα.
With 10 children.
Μιλάμε στα ελληνικά γιατί χρειάζεται να μιλήσουμε εδώ, να το τιμήσουμε. I just said we're speaking in Greek to honor him.
Yes, absolutely.
To hear some Greek words here, probably he was talking to himself in Greek. That's nice to converse.
Oh, you never know, maybe he can hear that.
I spent so long in the paddock because I ploughed it all with the tractor around and around a couple of times. I really felt that one night going home I'd find him.
Yes.
You know, his spirit would come out. Yeah,
sometimes I get that feeling.
Which one's Gikas?
This one here.
So how'd you figure?
Because reading about them, he was a shorty. He was short. And he was taller. So that's why I painted them that way. I'm an artist.
What about the faces?
Well, this is how I see them.
Yeah.
He's very clever. You can see that he's very clever.
Because he's sitting?
No, you can see the way his eyes shine and the way he's looking. He's more docile. He's a sheep herder. This one here is into all sorts of things.
But he didn't marry.
They both married.
I didn't think he did.
No,
Gikas married.
Yeah, and so did he.
He had 10 kids, Gikas.
Yeah, he was very fertile. This one here got married too, but you know, he had one son and he died. Manolis Adonis' son died, so he didn't have any other children. A historian, Dr. Panagiotis Diamantis, told me about them. I didn't even know they existed. I was shocked. There's so much history we don't know about.
What about the people in the foreground?
Looking at ships, I had to paint a ship. I Googled the different convict ships, and I found this picture, and I liked it, so I pretty much copied it, but put more stuff into it and changed the colour. I put a little dog and just changed it. Because you need reference in art. Because I had no idea about ships. Never painted a ship. This is the first time I've painted a ship. Because nobody could tell me anything about them, I tried.
So this is the ship, isn't it?
Yeah. You see, she's got her baby with her on her breast. And these girls are just jumping, and they've got their children and their mothers. When I had my launch at Campbelltown Art Centre, I had a screen 5 metres by 5 metres. And I had this picture on the screen. And I had the music playing of that song, Zanlongo. There's a special song that these girls were singing and dancing to. And I had girls in traditional costume dancing to it and then disappearing into the screen. Actually, I'll send it to you. It's not a very good one, but I'll send it to you. It's really emotional. I had the mayor of Camden, I had the mayor of Wollondilly, and I had the mayor of Campbelltown there, and they had the goosebumps on their goosebumps.
I was having a chat with one of the kids out there.
I'm trying to chat with me.
They don't want to leave the stage. Okay.
Oh, so you're the teacher?
Yeah, mate.
What do you think of them?
Yeah, they're pretty good. They're pretty well started.
They're all excited.
Huh?
They're all excited.
They are very excited.
Oh,
infrastructure of
I had fun dancing.
Yeah,
and it was really
now,
good.
Yeah. Yeah. That was amazing how you took the lead and you did it.
Yeah, thank you.
Really good.
Water.
Top marks.
Makes it a little bit easier for you.
Have a wonderful day. Let's enjoy as much as we can, even though it's the weather's not the best. But the Greek spirit always is the best.
you been doing it?
Someone has to go there, so
who's a better dancer?
Yeah, they went pretty well actually.
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, this is the first time in a couple of years I've done it.
That was awesome. Yeah, they did so well. Thanks.
This is the one, is it? Is this yours?
Yeah, that's Elijah.
This is him. How you been?
Yes, sir. Good.
How come you're not dancing?
Did I feel like it?
You're giving up. You're a teenager now, are you?
Pardon?
You're a teenager now, are you?
Yeah.
So you're a teenager, you didn't feel like it, huh?
Oh, no, I'm starting again soon. Just not right now.
You're enjoying today?
Yeah, very much.
What advice do you give to young people?
Start just being like learning Greek and Greek dancing from very young. It can really help when you grow up.
Bye.
we're going to get to Athens.
Thank you.
Next one.
Next month. Yeah.
You enjoying yourself? So this is.
Dance around your pup.
Yeah, story about this. You know Hugues Lacroix, the famous artist? He's painted a beautiful painting, which I think is in the Louvre, and it's called Exodus from Missolonghi. And it's a beautiful woman, like with her arms like that, like frustrated because there's a war. And I looked at that painting and I'm thinking, she's in Missolonghi. At that time, it was horrible there. The war, they were slaughtering people, they had no food, it was bad. And I just thought I'd change it and make it more dramatic to honour these women. So I've got the glass and I made it black and I asked the guy who framed it to leave the canvas. I didn't want it closed because I want to bring out the feeling of that time. And the way she's sitting is the way that famous painting is, which is like that.
So what do you do with all the paintings?
I just paint. And people want to buy some, but I prefer to, if I'm going to give them to somebody or sell them to somebody, I prefer somebody to buy them and exhibit them. So people go, this is all about the younger generation, Greeks and non-Greeks, to know history. It's all about, you know, I don't want people to buy them and put them in their lounge room. I want them to go somewhere where people can look at them, appreciate them. Yeah, it's of cultural significance.
This one here.
He's beautiful, isn't he? Lord Byron.
Is it Lord Byron, is it?
Nah.
He looks very Greek, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He doesn't look English at all, does he?
Yeah. But he was English.
So what made you dress him up that way?
Because I found a picture of him dressed like that, in that traditional costume. I saw a picture. And I just adore him because he was an incurable romantic. He was also bisexual. And he was very a ladies' man, and he was just a poet, and he was just so generous, and I just like him as a person.
Was he from Lesbos?
No, he's not a lesbian.
I'm a lesbian. You got any lesbians here?
No. That's my next series. That's my next series, mythology. That's my next series. This is Bubulina. She was the first woman admiral in the world till about 20 years ago, and the Russians have actually got a statue of her because they commemorate her. You know, she was the only woman admiral. She had her own fleet.
Of what?
Ships.
What navy?
Her own navy for the Greek independence.
Oh, so they were pirates, were they?
No, they fought for the War of Independence.
So they
she was tough. Look at her eyes. You don't mess with her. No. And this is beautiful, beautiful Manton Mavrogenos, noble woman who gave all her dowry to the cause and who was in love with Ypsilanti's brother Dimitri, who was a general, but they never got together. She was a sweetheart of that era, the Romantic era.
So all this is from the same period, is it?
No.
Tell me about the period.
Yeah. It's all about the Greek War of Independence. That's why I started painting. It's our bicentennial this year, 200 years.
200 years.
And I got very sick. And I thought if I'm going to die, I got cancer in 2018, breast cancer. And I had an operation and, you know, the treatments and blah, blah, blah. And I thought, if I'm going to die, I want to leave a legacy quickly. So I better quickly finish this series before I cark it. Now you've got something to laugh about.
That's wonderful. I just want to see your eyes, whether you're tough or not.
Oh, my eyes are tough.
Yeah, you're tough.
But I'm tired. Yeah. I've got chronic pain.
You just need to rest a little bit.
I'm very tired. This gentleman is asking me so many questions, and I've told him, you're the historian of the family.
So what do you think of your mum?
What I think of my mum? What can I say? I can't be objective about her. She's very talented and very honoured. Although she drives us, it's very hard living with an artist.
My name in Greek is Angeliki. So they used to call me Kiki from Angeliki when I was little. So I thought, that's a good name to keep as an artist name. Because people won't forget it, Angelikiki. Because my surname is Konstantinopoulou. I'm called after the city Constantinople. I'm very important.
What have you learnt being the daughter of, or being a Kiki? What have you learnt?
It's the passion.
passion. Whatever she does, she puts a lot of passion in her work. And when you have passion in something, you always succeed. And her idea was to keep the flair alive and keep the passion to the newer generations. It's always easier with a visual aid to help people remember things.